by no means was a disrespect, you know, towards that person, but at the same time, it was just kind of like, yeah, fuck you. For someone else could be heaven, so why is it hell? Ain't that what you're saying, baby? So that song is a song about all of our flames that should have burned out way sooner than they ever did. Thinking about you. Shout out to my ex. I went through a breakup with somebody who I really loved, who was really my first love. And I felt like I didn't get the closure that I really deserve. And so You Should Talk was sort of my way of formulating like my own version of closure. And it was meant both in a very literal sense in the way that, like, I wish you would talk to me. But it's also at the same time being like, I know that you're going around and saying shit to people all over town, but, you know, you should be one to talk because you did this too. Like, you ghosted me. You left me hanging here. I've played a part, and I take responsibility for that. And, like, I guess I'll wait for you to one day to do the same. Yeah, would you be- just kind of a video that is a bit of a fantasy land, and you're not really sure if it's happening in my head or not. And I'm breaking into the apartment of what could be like my ex's or my ex's new lover's apartment, and like trying on their clothes and things like that. It's a bit insane, but apparently I'm the girl who's insane and ruined everything. So it's a fitting video. Definitely like the most drama Fletcher has ever given off, so I'm excited for people to be able to see that side of me too. I never would have thought that New Music Friday would make my ex reach out 2 years later. Yeah. Applying to the Clive Davis Institute of Recorded Music at NYU kind of was really just a culmination of just a childhood of being super involved with music. But it was really there that like solidified my real desire to want to be an artist, but also with a focus on like the entrepreneurial mindset of being an artist. It was really intimidating to be surrounded by so many different people wanting to do the same thing as me. And I remember having a text conversation with my mom and being like, Mom, there's so many good songwriters here. Like, I don't think that I have what it takes to be a songwriter. Like, I don't know if that's something, if it's something that I can do or that I'm good at. And I would get really frustrated with myself. And then I ended up taking a year leave of absence where I went down to Nashville for about 6 months. And that's where I wrote my first ever EP, and War Paint was like one of the first songs that I've ever written with another co-writer. It was a song that I like fell in love with and felt like really represented me in my artist project, and that's kind of where it started. War Paint lyrically came from a place sort of struggling with self-identity and sexuality and trying to figure myself out and dealing with like input from family and having a really hard time with that. And War Paint is just a song that I really needed and wrote about wanting to shut out all the outside voices in the world and just like focus on who was making me happy and like who I was loving and fighting for that regardless of what other people were having to say about it. I'm obviously like a huge supporter and consider myself as part of the LGBT community. My mission is just to be me and show that I'm comfortable with myself, but it took a really long time to get here. Now more than ever, fans and audiences of music are craving sincerity and honesty and authenticity and are turning to artists that are offering that. I think it's important that if you're given this platform, that you use the opportunity to better not only yourself, but the world around you. And it's a dark place sometimes. And if we can have music and role models and inspirations and people to turn to, I think it really makes the world a better place.